I mean, it is pretty stunning. I mean, just before we talk about drugs, no drugs, I mean, what do you make of the performance of a 16-year-old beating the top American man?
Okay, so we have to put a few things in perspective here. First of all, she was trailing. This was her opportunity to make up ground and put herself in position to win a gold medal, whereas Ryan Lochte was ahead by 3 body lengths. He did not have to try hard in those last 20 to 30 meters of the pool. So that's right. One thing. I do want to believe that if someone really has been training their entire life, that they could put together one length of the pool where they
just
do
to
swim
sprint to put 100%.
A tenth of a second better than a man could.
All right. So you think that that's reasonable. But what about this whole issue about doping? A lot of people are saying, you know, in 1994, China dominated in swimming, 12 of 16 gold medals at the Worlds. Yeah. But 7 athletes, Chinese athletes, later tested positive for banned substances. So yeah. She says Chinese athletes don't dope. Obviously, that's not true historically. What do you think now?
And as recent as 2009, there were some Chinese athletes in the junior championships that got caught doping. But it's really dangerous to make that correlation right to Ye Shiwen. And that's not really fair to her either. I mean, look at baseball. Had such a huge problem with steroids for decades. And right. You wouldn't say that one person, just because the first baseman is doping, means the entire team is doing it too. I think we need to give her the benefit of the doubt now, because she will be tested. There's no doubt that she will be tested. She probably already has.
We'll
see when the results come
out. So does that work, though? Because I know there's about 10,500 athletes.
Yes.
Just over half of them get tested.
Sure.
So you've got a 50-50 chance. But if she gets tested now after winning, would every possible substance that could have influenced her performance actually still show up?
Absolutely. So she will get tested. The top 5 athletes in every event, plus 2 other athletes who compete in that event, all get tested. So if you win a medal, you're getting tested for every medal that you win. That's number one. She is definitely getting tested.
Yeah.
Secondly, they keep the test for 8 years. So as the technology of drug testing gets better and better, they will go back
and
retest.
So they could rescind the medal.
This has happened before. This happened to Marion Jones, the sprinter from Australia in 2000. So they can definitely go back and they can find out whether or not someone was cheating. They want to find the cheaters. That is definitely true. But you also have to give her, she's innocent until proven guilty.
Right, right. And I mean, it is a stupendous performance. I mean, and I want to just ask you this question, because
sure.
There was an American, Missy Franklin, who raced 2 swimming races 10 minutes apart. And people are saying, that's just so incredible, that performance. But why aren't people picking on her for doping? Is there some sort of an ethnocism going on here?
Well, I hope it's not an ethnocism. I think that we already talked about the reputation that the Chinese had, unfortunately, which should not reflect on Ye Shiwen. But what Missy Franklin did was qualify for one event and then get a gold medal in the next, less than 10 minutes apart from each other. And
that is
unbelievable. She didn't break any world records, no Olympic records in those races. I think the world record is really what raised people's eyebrows. And the fact that Ye Shiwen really decimated the world record by a full second, that raised eyebrows. But, you know, it could just be a phenomenal Olympic performance. I think that that's what everyone should take it as until we know more.
I hope.